A person who never made a mistake, never tried anything new. Have you experienced failure? Do you think you are a failure? Have you been told that you are a failure? No one likes to fail. Believe it or not, failure is necessary for growth. Failure is crucial for redirecting you to the path that's best for you. Failure is the best wake-up call to change for the better. Failure is the universe calling you out, compelling you to be true to yourself. While going through failure, you may find it almost impossible to appreciate its purpose. Think of a past failure. Do you have the same feelings about it right now? Or are you glad that it was a failure because you realize now that it's not the best option for you after all? To overcome failure, you've got to make it your ally. You heard me right. Make failure your ally. This doesn't mean that you have to go in search of failure. This doesn't mean that it's okay for you to be complacent and not do your best. What it means is, if you fail, make that failure your ally. Work with it. Work through it. Learn from it. Make use of that failure to eventually succeed. Make an ally of it. How can you overcome failure? Here are three amazing ways. Firstly, find the truth behind a failure and do something about it. I'm not talking about superficial reasons. For instance, it's too difficult for you. You are not ready. You are too lazy. No matter how hard you try, you'll never be good enough. These are reasons on the surface. They are also self-limiting beliefs. I am more interested in the root cause of your failure. Were you trying to fulfill someone else's expectations? Were you trying to keep up with the Joneses? Was your self-worth tied to that failure? Was your identity defined by that failure? Did you believe in what you were doing and why you were doing it? Were you being true to yourself in pursuing it? Did you believe in yourself? Whatever the root cause of your failure, find it, admit it, and do something about it. Rectify the situation. You may decide to pursue something completely different, but this time, it's what you're truly interested in. You may wish to double down on your effort and work on your self-confidence to achieve success. You may now realize that you had unrealistic expectations of yourself. You may wish to get help to succeed. The challenge lies in admitting to the truth behind your failure. That may not be easy for some. Secondly, treat failure as an experiment. Failure is a sign that you are still in the process of figuring out what's best for you. To find out exactly what works for you, you have to first know what your options are. How many of these options are you willing to explore? Try out your options. Experiment with them. Each experience will help you decide which way you prefer to go. By the way, you've got to be absolutely honest with yourself throughout this process. There is no room for he said, she said, and they said. Don't be in a rush. Give yourself enough time to make a wise choice. Above all, trust your intuition to guide you. Trust that you will choose what's best for you. Thirdly, detach from any failure you experience. This doesn't mean that you don't take responsibility for your actions. It means that failure does not define you. Failure does not determine your worth. Do your best to achieve your desired outcome. Know that there are things beyond your control. Acknowledge the effort you have made. Don't judge yourself if the outcome is unfavorable. Instead, immediately divert your attention to the next plan of action. Think about your next strategy. If you keep yourself occupied with positive and productive thoughts, you will be motivated to take inspired action. You will be motivated to succeed, no matter how long or how many attempts it takes. Stay positive, and it will be impossible for failure to drag you down. Keep in mind, in order to succeed, your desire for success should be greater than your fear of failure.